Have The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you, who now know, one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we work, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is a sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways, for you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord blesses you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Whoever keeps the word of Christ, the love of God is truly perfected in him.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous. And you say, if we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would have not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood. Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are children of those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord.
On the outside, you're lovely, but on the inside, you're ugly. Jesus shows his stormy side again when he utters the last of seven warnings to scribes and Pharisees. It's the most devastating indictment of all of them. Jesus charges them with hypocrisy. The dictionary describes hypocrisy as pretending to be something we are not. Ancients often buried their dead above ground in tombs. Those burial chambers were whitewashed on the outside so they looked really pretty. Jesus said the offering, Jesus told the offerings, scribes and Pharisees, offending ones rather, you are like the whitewashed tombs, which look fine on the outside, but are full of bones and decaying corpses on the inside. The question for us today is, do we ever pretend to be what we are not? Lord, help us realize that we try to make an impression on someone. When we try to do that, that's exactly the impression that we give them. And worse yet, it even dishonors us more. Let us pause now to offer our petitions to our Father.
This Mass is offered by the repose of the soul of Raymond Hall and Ed Potter. For these intentions, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, may God grant within her people a purity of heart and genuine witness of his love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in positions of government and civic leadership, may Christ inspire them in modeling self-sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from COVID-19, may the Lord sustain them through his loving presence and the generosity of his people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they may be protected by God watching over them and return safely to their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may God look favorably and generously upon the work of our hands, that it may be for his glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, including William Lizowski, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may they now rejoice in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and euthanasia throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, we ask you to hear the prayers which we bring before you humbly, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God, our bread.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice for the praise of the Lord and for our good and the love of the Church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your Church. Through Christ,
Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior, the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice. us of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your word, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be yours.
Thank you. body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus, Lord of our